Okay, so I brought it back down here because it's shade and it's like 11:30 and it's already like 90 degrees. Let's get to like 95 or 97 today, which is ridiculous. But all right, so if you saw the video where I washed it after I did that, I realized the fuel filter or water evaporator, whatever, was leaking, and then I realized I didn't zip tie it. So I did find a couple of zip ties actually in here. So I zip tied it. It doesn't seem to be leaking anymore, but it does seem like it's out of gas, which I only put like 2 gallons in it. So we're gonna put some gas in it, put some more of the seafoam marine fuel treatment in it. Also, I think I'm gonna take the spark plugs out. And someone on a video I had watched, I think it was a video, they poured a little two-cycle oil down the plugs just to help lubricate it because it had been sitting so long, which I sprayed some seafoam on it. Well, I don't have any two-stroke oil at the moment, so I'm gonna spray some more of the seafoam, the top engine cleaner and lube, in there. And then we're gonna put some gas in it, and we're gonna hopefully hear it start up, because I'm really hoping it's just that it doesn't have any gas. So let's get to it. All right, that's all good. I'm gonna go throw on some zip ties for the parts that I took off. Also, I noticed I didn't do a very good job picking up the, tightening the cables back down, so I gotta do that as well. Tightened up. I just took that off to make it easier for me to put zip ties on these. Yeah, I should have gotten the longer zip ties like these ones were. Pain trying to get those things down in there. Thank you. there. Enough. Oh, this stupid thing. Okay, I just can't get my fat hands down there to be able to tighten that thing up. Well, that was a huge pain. If you're gonna do that, I would definitely go with the bigger zip ties. It's easier to use, and then you can just clip them. I had just had some of those for whatever reason. Anyway, so I'm gonna go ahead and put some of the seafoam gas treatment in the tank, add a couple gallons of gas, hopefully get her to fire off. We'll see. Alright, so I'm only going to put a couple gallons, and since I've already used some of it, I'm just going to do 2 ounces per gallon, so I'm putting 4 ounces. Okay, so that's about 2 gallons. It's the non-ethanol. That's what you're really supposed to use in the two-stroke motors. Plus, ethanol eats away at the gas lines. It doesn't feel like the water is... It's starting to come out now, but... The tube that splits off to go to the engine to cool it doesn't seem like it had water in it. You can just squeeze it. I think there might be a blockage or something. Okay, it sounds like water's moving through there, so hope so. I'm not gonna let it run too long. Take it to the lake. It's got to get registered and everything, but I really want it to run on its own power and to suck water in itself. It must be shooting out water, but I've seen other ones like Sea-Doos, people work on them and have water hooked up, and those do, but I haven't seen anyone working on these where it should have been running on hose water. And it doesn't look like any more gas is leaking from the fuel filter, but it doesn't appear to be leaking now that I've zip tied them. That's good, but I'm probably still gonna order that part. Even though when I checked it, it looked really clean. They're only like $15. So, figured it'd be worth it.